make it good.
So I needed an outlet. So I went on Craigslist and I put up an ad looking for musicians to start a band with me. And I met these two guys that were awesome. Shane, my drummer, and then John, who ended up being my bass player. And the three of us recorded some songs and put together an album. And it really, I mean, I guess at that point, I definitely had like dreams that this was gonna be, you know, a real band and that we were gonna get big.
Cut the small talk, cut to the chase, cut the cord, cut the crap.
I definitely had like dreams that this was gonna be, you know, a real band and that we were gonna get big. But it wasn't until our single kind of surprisingly took off, sort of out of nowhere, that I kind of said, oh, this, I could do this. Like, this is not just a pipe dream. This is something that I could actually do. Right. So that's kind of how it happened. I mean, I sort of fell into it. I don't want to say backwards, but it's not like I was somebody who knew from a young age. Like, I wasn't like, you know, singing with the microphone in front of my, or singing with the hairbrush microphone in front of my mirror. Like, that was definitely not me. You know, it was sort of almost reverse engineered, where it was like I had the success, and then because I had success, I was like, oh, I guess this is a dream I had.
Yeah, you got me right where you want me.
I don't think I loved it the way that you're supposed to love it if you want to do, if you want to perform for a living. You know, the music industry is so, so hard, and there's so many pitfalls and so much rejection and just so many really hard things about it. The only highlights of it really are writing, recording, and performing. And if you're not enjoying any of those, then, or, you know, if you're not enjoying one of them, then like, why are you doing it? Because it's so hard overall. You know, you really have to love those highlights. And I found myself always feeling a little awkward after shows, like, really, you want to meet me? Like, you want me to sign stuff? Like, why me? Like, it just, I think to be a lead singer, you have to have a certain level of narcissism. And I mean, I'm not gonna lie, like, I definitely have it to an extent. I think I needed enough narcissism to be able to even, you know, have a band in the first place, but I don't think I had enough of it to thrive on it.
Every bone in my body screams, Steffi, baby, just stay away.
It was just the actual live performance of it that I wasn't crazy about. And so I was thinking, like, okay, well, what can I do that will let me write and record but not have to perform? And so I figured out, I was like, oh, well, I'll just be a behind the scenes songwriter for Katy Perry and Rihanna and stuff like that. As if that's like, I thought, I was so dumb. I thought that was like an easy job you can just walk into. Like, oh, nobody wants to do that. Like, I will sacrifice. I will volunteer as tribute. I will write all of the top 40 hits. Not realizing how competitive that part of the industry is. In a lot of ways, it's even harder and more competitive than like being an artist in your own right.